Hey everyone, happy to have you here with me once again. Welcome back to my channel. If you're new, you can call me Tanon and this is my channel. And today, as you can see in the title, we're having the second ranking of the end of the year. Last week we had the ranking of my bronzers and today we're going to be ranking my highlighters. And to be honest, the idea of ranking my highlighters was really scary because I feel like they're kind of similar. Like, I don't have too many crazy colors in my highlighters, and at least at the beginning I felt like all of my highlighters were kind of the same. But then I started swatching one by one and trying them on my face, trying to remember how I feel about each of them. And it was crazy because, for example, a highlighter that I thought it was going to be like in the fifth place, it ended up like in the ninth place, and things start to move around. But yeah, I don't want to make this introduction any longer, so let's start with place number 12. Okay, we have 13 highlighters, but two of them I will count as one because at least for me it's kind of the same. But I'm only counting duos and singles. I'm not counting any of my highlighter palettes or face palette that has highlighter on them. So with that out of the way, let's start with place number 12. In number 12, it's kind of funny because I have the only highlighter that I have in my collection that is not a powder. And that is this highlighter over here, this thick highlighter from Wet n Wild. I have the shade When the Nude Strikes. And I feel like this is a pretty good color. It's kind of pinky, and I will say this is the one that looks more natural on my skin when I'm not under direct sunlight. But my issue with it is the formula and the smell. This smells like vinegar, and I really don't like that. It has smelled like that since the day I got it, and I don't know if it expired since the first moment or it's just the way it is and it's supposed to smell like this. But I really don't like the smell. Even if I like the color and how it looks on my cheeks, the smell is just too bad. And maybe it's just the way it is because I have heard that other physician formula, like stick products, smell bad too. And I think their physician formula and Wet n Wild are from the same owner, so maybe it's just the way it is. But yeah, for that reason, I decided to rank this one as number 12. In number 11, I'm going to be mentioning two products because I feel like for me, they kind of serve the same purpose and they're kind of the same but in different colors. And I want to mention these two little palettes from e.l.f. These are duos and I have Blue Lagoon and Mermaid Tail. These are my Fang highlighters on my collection. And to be honest, I bought this because I really wanted the Alchemist palette from Kat Von D, but that was a little bit more expensive, so I decided to go with these two. But to be honest, I was expecting something a little bit more dramatic, more intense, and these ones didn't really give me that. So for that reason, I think they're in number 11 because I have higher expectations and they didn't meet those expectations. But yeah, I bought this to use as an eyeshadow, like an inner corner, or just to play around with them. And I feel like they're nice, I like them, but they feel super dry, so I'm always afraid they're going to be looking super dry on my skin, but they don't, so I guess it's just a fear of mine. For number 10, I'm a little bit embarrassed to show this product, first because I broke my Novi because of this product, and also because I've been mentioning this brand so many times in my channel lately, but always saying that I don't want to support this brand. And then I go and buy more products from them. So yeah, I'm a little bit ashamed, but don't judge me, please. And I'm going to be mentioning this highlighter over here from Physician Formula. But well, this is an iridescence highlighter. It's actually the one that I'm using today, but I use it super lightly because I didn't want it to look too purple on my cheeks because yeah, this is super intense and super purple. It's beautiful, don't take me wrong. But now that I spent the money on it and I have used it, I'm like, I didn't need this. Why did I bought this? This is the one that is higher from the e.l.f. ones. First because it's way more intense, but also because I like the formula better. As I mentioned, the e.l.f. ones really feel dry when I touch them. But this is more like a super chalk shadow, so it's super creamy and it almost feels wet. And I like that. It's a good experience. Smells weird, but I think it doesn't bother me. But well, I thought I should mention that. But well, this is in number 10. In number 9, I have a product that I thought it was going to be way higher, and that is my More Than Glow highlighter from Catrice in the shade Platinum Gaze, Platinum Glaze, I think it is. And this is a highlighter that I thought it was going to be so much higher, but when I start comparing this one with others, I realize that the others I like way better. And I think this is one of the most intense highlighters on my collection. But it's too much. It's just too much. It's almost metallic, so if you use a little bit too much of this product, will look like a metallic line in your cheeks. And you don't want that. And I feel also like this product looks better under direct sunlight than not, because if the sun is not directly hitting it, it looks like you have something in your cheek. And I prefer something that if the light is not directly hitting it, it looks more natural. I don't expect like a highlighter to look like I'm not wearing highlighter. I'm okay, like, if you can notice that I'm wearing highlighter, but this is a little bit too much. In number 8, we have a product that I thought it was going to be even lower, and that is my Moon Glow from NYX Cosmetics. And this is a product that the formula I really like. It's also a cream to powder formula, so it's really smooth, and if you apply it correctly and you work it into your skin, it can look really natural. But my issue with it is that I feel like there is a little bit of green on it. I don't know if I'm crazy, but every time that I apply it, I feel like there is kind of like a green reflection on it. And I don't really love that. I thought this one it was going to be lower than the Catrice one that I used to show you. But since it looks more natural on the skin, I decided to go with this one. And also, it's not like it's a green highlighter. I'm not saying that. But I feel like there is something when I look at it that looks green, but maybe I'm crazy, maybe I am. I'm going to wear my glasses now because I have my notes over here and it's getting really hard for me to read them without my glasses. But in number 7, I have these Moonlight Pearls from e.l.f. and I feel like this product is almost a perfect dupe for the next one that I'm going to show you, but this one is way, way, way more cheaper, like a tenth of the price. But this is a highlighter that you can apply it and it looks like nothing, but I feel like it's kind of traitorous, because sometimes you apply it and it looks super natural and almost like nothing, but some other times I apply a little bit too much and it looks really heavy on my skin. So I feel like this is a little bit traicionero. Again, I don't know how to say that word in English. But yeah, this is a really nice product, but only 90% of the times, because the other times I still don't understand why it doesn't work the same for me. And then we have number 6, and this is a really expensive product, but I feel like it works almost the same than the one that I just showed you, the one from e.l.f. And that is my Charlotte Tilbury Filmstar Bronze and Glow Palette. I'm talking about the highlighter on it, well, of course. And as I said, I feel like it looks so similar, swatched and on the cheeks, that the one from e.l.f. Weird, if you ask me, but that's okay for me. This is another highlighter that looks really natural on your skin. It doesn't have like a lot of pigment base or base pigment. And for the same reason, if the light is not hitting your cheek, you cannot almost see it. It's not there until the light hits your skin. And that's something that I really enjoy. This is a product that I really enjoy, but it's way too expensive. Now we're on the top 5, and in the place number 5, we have the Sister of the Platinum Glaze that I just showed you in the place number 9. This is also from the More Than Glow line from Catrice, but this one is in the shade Supreme Rose Beam. And it's funny for me that I like this one better than the other one, but because I have warm undertones, so golden should look better on me. And this one is more of a pink highlighter. But I feel like this one looks better on my skin. I don't know why, but I feel like it's even more manageable. Like, I don't have to be that careful when I apply it because it doesn't look that intense on my cheeks, and I like that. But out of that, out of the jade, this is basically the same as the platinum gaze, so it's a super metallic highlighter, so you need to be careful. But for some reason, I feel like with this one, I can be a little bit more reckless and it's going to be okay. With the other one, I really need to be careful. In number four, we have my Lunch Money highlighter from ColourPop. And this, I feel like, is one of my more wearable highlighters on my collection because it doesn't have a lot of shimmers. It's a nice color. You don't have to be careful with it. It's a really comfortable highlighter for me to wear. The thing is, I think the color might be a little bit too light, and that makes me think that maybe I should try more highlighters from ColourPop because I really like the formula. But out of that, I feel like it's something that blends really easily on your skin. This one has a little bit more of a solid base to it, so you really need to blend it into the skin so it's unnoticeable almost. And that could be a good or bad point depending on your preferences. But yeah, as I said, this is a really comfortable highlighter for me to wear. I don't need to worry too much when I apply this one, and I like that. And in the other hand, we have number three, that it's the complete opposite, because I have the Flexitarian highlighter from ColourPop, and this highlighter is pure magic, because this is one of the most intense and beautiful and shimmery and reflecting highlighters that I have in my entire collection. I think you can see this highlighter even in the dark. It's that intense. The thing is that for the same reason, I have to be really careful when I apply it, or it's going to be too much too fast. You need to really apply the smallest amount, or people in space will be able to see your highlighter. If that's something that you like, maybe this is your perfect product. But for me, it's a little bit too much sometimes, but it's something so special and it looks so stunning. But I think this is a highlighter that I wouldn't recommend if you're going to be like in the outside during sunlight, because as I said, it's a little bit too much. But if you're not directly under direct sunlight, it looks so natural. No, not natural. What am I saying? This doesn't look natural ever. No. This is not a natural highlighter, but it's a stunning product. And even if it's really hard for me to use it, I really like it. And now we have the top two. And in number two, I have my Just My Type highlighter. And I feel like this could be my perfect highlighter because it has the right amount of shimmer. And I feel like even if sometimes I feel like the color is a little bit too light, especially if, for example, I under a roof. But I feel like when the sun hits my skin, it has the same color, the same reflection as this highlighter. And that makes it so special. But the thing is that maybe when I get a little bit more of a tan, I don't tan a lot, maybe it will be too light. I haven't tried this one in summer because I have only played around with it in winter, because I got it in winter of this year. But I don't know, it's like this could be like the color of my cheeks under the sun, a little bit more intense of course because it's a highlighter, but the same shade as my skin under the sun. Do you get what I'm trying to say? Am I explaining myself at all? I don't know, but this is a really beautiful product. But the thing is, sometimes I feel like it looks too noticeable if I'm not under direct sunlight or indirect light in general. And for that reason, it's only in place number two, but this is really high because this is a product that I really enjoy. And the last product, the number one, my favorite highlighter ever. I got my vaccine today and it's starting to hurt. I wasn't expecting to have this highlighter so high because this is a product that for the first year that I got it, I almost didn't use it. But in the last couple of months, I've been playing around with it like crazy. And now I just love it. And it's my favorite highlighter right now. And that is my Precious Petal from Wet n Wild. That, by the way, this is another brand that I will not like to try more from because they're in the gray zone in their cruelty-free status. But I said that about Physician Formula and I bought more of them anyway, so I cannot trust myself, but that is not the point. This is my most golden highlighter on my whole collection, and maybe for that reason it's so high, because I feel like that goes really well with my warm undertone. But I feel like this is a product that will look spectacular on winter, on summer, under a direct sunlight or not, because if I compare this highlighter with this one over here, since this is a little bit more golden and my skin is a little bit more golden, if the light is not hitting my skin, it looks more natural because kind of blends more easily into my skin. Instead, this one can be a little bit more icy, not really icy, but a little bit more platinum maybe, more champagne. And for that reason, you can see it a little bit more. But this one looks perfect in sunlight, without sunlight, even in the night looks pretty. It has the right amount of shimmer on it. You can see it, it's not like a natural highlighter at all, but I'm not looking for that in a highlighter, and I think for that this is my favorite highlighter right now. But yeah, that's everything for today. This was a hard video to film because explaining the difference between 13 highlighters is not an easy task, but I hope you enjoyed this video. If you like it, please consider subscribing, I would love that. And I hope I'll see you in the next one. Oh, and remember that right now we're having Vlogmas, so we're going to be having a video every single day until Christmas. So we're going to have a lot of content over here. So if you're interested, again, please consider subscribing. But I hope I'll see you in the next one. Bye!